Hello students, I hope everything's okay with you, all of you. Today we're going to start lecture number 5, which is the themes in Animal Farm. Okay, themes in animals, theme or themes, are the main idea or original meaning a writer explores in a novel, short story or other literary work. A story's theme can be carried out using characters, settings, dialogue, plot, or a combination of all of these elements. أكيد مر عليكم الثيم. هسه نسمعها واي ثيم. عندنا يقولون ثيمة، شنو الثيمة مالت الحفلة مثلا؟ هي هاي الثيم، الفكرة. In simple stories, the theme may be a moral or a message. يعني في القصص العادية قد يكون حكمة أو رسالة يريد الكاتب يوصلها للقراء. The central theme is typically a more open-ended exploration of some fundamental aspects of society or humanity in more complex stories. يعني شخص إنه في القراءة أو الكتابة أكو ثيمات اللي هو الموضوعات، هي الفكرة الرئيسية أو المعنى الأصلي الذي يستكشفه الكاتب في رواية أو قصة قصيرة أو عمل أدبي. يمكن تنفيذ موضوع القصة باستخدام شخصيات أو إعداد حوار أو حبكة أو مزيج من كل هاي العناصر اللي تكلمنا عنها. In simple stories, في القصص البسيطة قد يكون الموضوع أخلاقيا أو رسالة. عادة ما يكون الموضوع الرئيسي هو استكشاف مفتوح أكثر more open لبعض الجانب الأساسية للمجتمع أو الإنسانية في قصص أكثر تعقيداً. نبدأ نستكشف أفضل موضوعات الأدبية، تستكشف طبيعة الشخصية البشرية، خلينا نقول على مستوى عالمي. فلاحظ أكثر الكتب بها ثيمات متشابهة. Most نقول the best literary themes explore human nature on a universal level. It's no surprise, فليس من المستغرب. Multiple books may share the same central idea. Each of the following famous themes, هسا احنا نحكي على famous themes. Examples reveals the human condition and offers readers food for thought long after the story ends. يعني تقدم فكرة يظل بال القارئ لفترة طويلة حتى بعد أن تنتهي القصة، حتى يستكشف هاي المشكلة أو الفكرة اللي الكاتب حاول يحطها. نأتي الآن للsix common themes in literature. أغلب الروايات أكو themes متتكرر دائما، good versus evil، love الحب، redemption اللي هي الخلاص. شو يقصد بالredemption؟ redemption is a major theme in literature. Redemption is the salvation of a soul that is lost, usually from human error such as greed or envy, but also from the devil's interference in the salvation process. يقصد هو الخلاص دائما يكون هذا موضوع رئيسي في الأدب. مثلا يتكلم عن النفس المفقودة، وإذا أكو شخص ارتكب خطأ بشري مثل الجشع أو الشهوة، حتى وكيف الشيطان يتدخل في عملية الخلاص. هاي أهم ثيم يتكرر. Courage and perseverance الشجاعة. Coming of age اللي هو coming of age يعني يقصد قصص المراهقة، يعني مرحلة المراهقة مع الشباب اللي دائما بها مشاكل. والثيم السادس الأخير اللي هو الريفنج الانتقام. The first one let's explain it more. The struggle for supremacy between Leon Trotsky and Stalin emerges in the rivalry between the pigs, Snowball and Napoleon. In both the historical and fictional cases, the idealistic but politically less powerful figure Trotsky, اللي هو تمثل شخصية Snowball, is expelled from the revolutionary state by the malicious and violent usurper of power, Stalin and Napoleon. the purges and the show and the purges and show trials with which Stalin eliminated his enemies and solidified his political base find expression in Animal Farm as the false confessions and executions of animals that Napoleon distrusts following the collapse of the windmill. Stalin's tyranny, rule, and eventual abandonment of the founding principles of the Russian Revolution are represented by the pigs turned to violent government and the adoption of human traits and behaviors, the trappings of their original oppressors. بدأوا يكرروا نفس الأخطاء خلينا نقول الأحكام اللي السابقين كان ينفذونها على المواطنين. Although Orwell believed strongly in socialist ideals, he felt that the Soviet Union realized these ideals in a perverse form. His novella creates its most powerful ironies in the moment in which Orwell depicts animalism, animalistic ideals, corruption by those in power. For Animal Farm serves not so much as condemn tyranny or dystopianism as to indict the horrifying hypocrisy of tyrannies that base themselves on and owe their initial power to ideologies of liberation and equality. The gradual disintegration and perversion of the Seven Commandments illustrates this hypocrisy with vivid force as to Squealer's elaborate philosophical justifications for the pig's bluntly unprincipled actions. Thus, the novella critiques the Stalinism regime violence against human beings it ruled and points to Soviet communism violence against human logic, language, and ideals. The societal tendencies towards class stratification. Animal Farm offers commentary on the development of class tyranny and the human tendency to maintain and re-establish class structures, even societies that allegedly stand for total equality. The novella illustrates how initially unified classes in the face of common enemy, as the animals are against the humans, may become internally divided when that enemy is eliminated. Of course, let's talk more about this. The expulsion of Mr. Jones creates a power vacuum, and it is only so long before the next oppressor assumes totalitarian control. The natural division between the intellectual and the physical labor quickly expresses itself as a new set of class division, with the brain works, as the pigs claim to be, using their superior intelligence to manipulate society to their benefit. Orwell never clarifies in Animal Farm whether the sad state of affairs constitutes an inherent aspect of society or merely an outcome contingent on society's intelligentsia integrity. In either case, the novella points to the force of their tendency towards class stratification in many communities as threat to democracy and freedom. شنو يقصد؟ يقصد انه صاروا طبقة البيجز اللي يعتبروا نفسهم اذكياء، طبقة الحيوانات الباكية اللي هم العمال. فأورو شنو يقول؟ انه يقول اغلب المجتمع تصير هيجي stratification، يعني تحط طبقات بالمجتمع اللي هي danger، خطورة على الديمقراطية والحرية. Okay, number three, the danger of a naive working class. خطورة الطبقة، سذاجة الطبقة العاملة. One of the novella's most impressive accomplishments is the portrayal not just of the figures in power but also of the oppressed people themselves. Animal Farm is not told from the perspective of any particular character, though occasionally it does slip into Clover's consciousness. صح، نلاحظ انه اغلب الحالات هي تتكلم، لكن دائما كلوفر هو الراوي. خلينا نقول instead the story is told from the perspective of the common animals as a whole، وكان رواه مروي وكانه الحالات كلها تتكلم تروي القصه للقارئ. gullible، طبعا الحيوانات ليش gullible؟ loyal and hard working. These animals give Orwell a chance to sketch how oppression situations arise, not only from the motives and tactics of the oppressors, but also from the naivety of the oppressed, who are not necessarily in position to be better educated or informed. When presented with a dilemma, Boxer prefers not to puzzle out the implications of various possible actions, but instead repeats to himself, Napoleon is always right. شو يقول إنه بوكسر من يبدي يشك إن نابليون بدأ يغير المبادئ وما يطبقها بدل ما يواجهه أو questionت يعني يبدي يفكر يقوم يعود روحه إنه يكرر مقولة نابليون is always right. نابليون دائما على حق. Animal Farm demonstrates how the inability or unwillingness to question authority condemns the working class. يحاول يظهر لكم عدم قدرة أو عدم رغبة الطبقة العاملة في أن تواجه الطبقة الحاكمة. Okay, let's go to number four. Number four, the abuse of language as instrumental to is instrumental to the abuse of power. The abuse of language as instrumental to the abuse of power. One of Orwell's central concerns, both in Animal Farm and in 1984. طبعا 1984 أهم رواية ثانية جدا شهيرة لأورويل. أكيد كل ما ينذكر Animal Farm لأورويل لازم تنذكر 1984. The central theme بها دائما is how language can be manipulated as an instrument of control. In Animal Farm, the pigs gradually twist and distort the socialist revolution's rhetoric. فعلا خلال Animal Farm الخنازير gradually بصورة تدريجية تبدي تتلاعب بالأفكار الاشتراكية للثورة to justify their behavior and keep the other animals in the dark حتى يبررون تصرفاتهم ويخلون باقي الحيوانات بالظلام يعني ما تعرف السبب. The animals heartily embrace Major's visionary ideas of socialism, but after Major dies, the pigs gradually twist his words' meaning. الحيوانات بالبداية فرحت بالأفكار أفكار ميجر، لكن بعد ما توفى الخنازير تبدي تتلاعب بالمعاني ببطء يعني شوي شوي. As a result, the other animals seem unable to oppose the pigs without also opposing the rebellion's ideas. يبدون لاحظوا أنه أنت إذا أصرت ضد أفكار الخنازير يعتبرك تصرد ضد أفكار الثورة. By the end, after Squeal's repeated reconfigurations of the seven commandments in order to decriminalize the pigs' treacheries, the main principle of the farm can be openly stated as all animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others. This outrageous abuse of the word equal and the ideal of equality in general typifies the pig's method, which becomes increasingly audacious. As the novel progresses, Orwell's sophisticated exposure to this abuse of language remains one of the most compelling and enduring features of Animal Farm, worthy of close study even after decoding its allegorical characters and events. يقول يعني حتى نبدي ندرسها ونلاحظ كيف أورويل بعد حاول اسمه يمثل لنا تصرفات الخنازير حط لها رموز حط لها معاني حتى نفتهم تصرفات الدكتاتور بهاي السلطة شلون يتصرف. And that's it. Thank you. That's our fifth lecture. See you in lecture number 6.